Good. Are you doing a quick tour real quick?
All right,
Chef, show me what we got.
We got some copas and some lomos here curing. We got some Osmal poke salami right here. We got some fermented miso beef right here. We got some metka right here. Some fit, some fatback, some of that 2016 Fiocco and Culatello from a way-fed pig.
Man, the good stuff.
Yo, Michael here. Welcome to my first vlog. Right now I'm in Madrid, Spain. Just got here this weekend. But before we start with Spain, let's begin in Atlanta. Before we go and spend some time at Wrecking Bar Brewpub, I want to talk about this vlog. Yeah, this vlog is going to be about food, about cooking, about people in the world, and how it connects us all. And I'm gonna be traveling a little bit. I wanted to share that with everyone. But first things first, back in my hometown, repping the ATL UTD jersey. We're gonna be Wrecking Bar Brewpub, making classic Dill Pickles. All right, y'all.
Cucumbers, 20 pounds, crushed dill, hard peeled garlic, thank you very much. We got whole black peppercorns, this is dill seed, and then we got bay leaf. The bay leaf, there's like three or four leaves in here, and I crush them up so I can disperse them evenly throughout. Classic ingredients, you know, are these right here. And the bay leaf is for adding tannins and more flavor. A classic addition for adding tannins, which help with crispiness, is gonna be grape leaf or something like that, walnut leaf. But I don't have any of those right now, so we're gonna use bay leaf. And then of course, to help us start our microbial production, I have some filtered juice. We make our own lactofermented sauerkraut here from a spontaneous fermentation, meaning we just add salt and let the natural bacteria start to form. And then it extracts juices, which create its own brine for preservation. I use some of that brine, not too much, just a little bit to add to my saltwater brine, which I have right here. This is my salt measured out by weight and diluted into water that we'll add as our brine. Important thing, layer everything in so the flavors, you know, mix evenly. So we'll add some pickles, fresh dill, garlic, peppercorns, bay leaf, dill seed, and repeat. Layer it all in. What's up, Chef? What's up, Chef? How you doing? I like our microgreen setup in the background. Pretty baller. Yeah, let's check
it out. We got
some
baller stuff here.
Yeah, fresh microgreens for the restaurant. All right, where was I? So just layering in everything. All our ingredients mixed in there, more or less evenly. Now we're gonna go ahead and add our brine. Our kraut starter. And then we're gonna use something non-metallic, always plastic, ceramic, never any metal, or else it'll react poorly with the bacteria. Now that was 9 liters of water. So as you can see, I just barely have the water level covering the pickles. It's key that we want to make sure that there's not too much water, or else the salt content in the water will be too low and it won't ferment properly. So now we have it ready. We're going to wrap it, seal it up a little bit because it's an anaerobic fermentation, and then put a date on it and make sure we remember what it is and when we made it. Terry speaking. Let's go see what. She was never lying, strutting in the hills or her slides. Either way, eyes on her every single day, week, year. Everyone wondering how she does it with no fear. All that confidence, was it heaven sent? Does it come within? Does it come run out? I don't know. She'll just have them running out and in. Man, they want to sin. Talking deadly sin with Mrs. Lady. I don't understand why she hit them like. Y'all, I'm gonna end right here. Thank you so much for watching. There's a definite learning curve to all this, so if anyone has some recommendations or comments, I'm open to them all. I'm sure the lighting isn't here perfect. This is the third time I've tried to make this shot in different locations, I'm sure I'll improve week to week. Right now, I'm gonna enjoy bocadillo de jamón ibérico. Classic Spanish sandwich, really simple. We'll talk more about that next week. But right now, let's end on a little B-roll of my weekend in Madrid. All right, peace.